Hello out there, YouTube land. God bless you. North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East, Far East. May you have a blessed Thanksgiving Day coming up here real soon. Won't be long. Be a little over 2 weeks here in the USA. And got another new prophecy today. Hurricane Sandy is judgment for Antichrist Obama. And my last prophecy, you need to come to the website, George and Betty Cully here on YouTube. Prophecy on White Horse Prophecy. It was fulfilled on November the 6th, 2012. I prophesied that Muslim Obama would defeat Mormon Mitt Romney, be with the close race. And for God's glory, I give him all this praise, honor, glory that prophecy come fulfilled. And here's a new prophecy. Straight from the throne room that Jesus gave to me. For the glory be to God. And you know, this nation is divided. President Obama ain't saving the union. The union been destroyed. The nation is divided right in half. With red states and blue states. And we're not going forward. We're going backwards. You're not seeing nothing. What's going to happen here now with Antichrist Obama, second term here. The things are going to get worse. Financial destruction, spiritual destruction, physical destruction. You know, this whole United States of America. Today, the sign from God, the handwriting on the wall is a crash of Wall Street. Because Wall Street know that the debt ceiling here is about ready to max out here. We could default on the bonds in the first year. Muslim Obama is going to raise the taxes on people, the rich here. And there's some bad moon rising, bad days ahead. You know, this is the beginning and the end. And I tell you what, I seen him last night. It just wanted to make me throw up. I was so sick that they was dancing in the streets there in Times Square Mall and right there around the White House, Washington, D.C. and Chicago, Illinois. They was partying and getting drunk and dancing, and it's a sad, sad old world. The last days, like the days of Noah, they'll be eating and drinking and marrying and just terrible. For 2 hours, they was worshiping the golden calf for the Antichrist Obama. And they don't realize that the mark of the beast is right there, not too far down the road. I believe when Obamacare happens, you know, coming up here 2013, 2014, but the date to watch now for the prophecy, Bible prophecy of God, that March the 13th, 2013 is going to be a bad year with Antichrist Obama, his Obamacare. That day he wants the people to have microchips. He wants to put a microchip under your right hand. That's taking the mark of the beast. It's going to be the mark of the beast. Care, medical. It ain't going to be Obamacare. And the people, he will deceive them. He's a wolf in sheep's clothing. The people didn't vote their pocketbook on this election. Jimmy Carter was the economy costing the election. George H. Bush, it was the economy. And President Bill Clinton says his economy, stupid, it cost him the election. This was supernatural. The Antichrist is deceived the people to put scales over their eyes and wolves over their eyes. Antichrist Obama, he should have lost this election if people voted the pocketbook. They didn't. They were deceived here. And anyway, you're going to see this thing happen. But while I'm getting back to the new throne room prophecy, Hurricane Sandy is judgment on Antichrist Obama. God sent that to the East Coast. 9 of the original 13 states, original colonies, was destroyed. Why was it destroyed? Because Antichrist Obama's got Obama's nation of desolation. Them states that got destroyed, they had same-sex marriages, abomination to the God of Israel. They all voted for Obama last night. And New York City got hit hard. First time the subways got wiped out. Why did New York City get hit so hard? Because the financial capital, the Wall Street fat cats, you know, it shut down Manhattan And I'm sorry some of the people out there, I thank you, Jesus, not too many people got killed, but in Long Island and Staten Island and in Brooklyn, Lord help the people suffering. But it's a judgment because of President Obama's. Blessed ones bless Israel, cursed ones that curse Israel. And that's what's happening out there. He's going against Israel, God's holy nation, land of milk and honey, Canaan's land. And while this hurricane hit the east coast there, Hurricane Sandy, God's judgment against Antichrist Obama. I felt like the judgment really started, the first judgment, on the National Day of Prayer in September, National Day of Prayer in May of 2009, the first judgment came on Antichrist Obama because he kicked the Christians out of the White House and he opened the doors to the Muslims, you know. The Muslims are welcome into the White House, but the Christians aren't. But President Obama has made the White House the Black House. This is not the race card. I'm talking about spiritual darkness in the land. Okaying same-sex marriages and abortions and illegal immigration. And this nation will suffer. The whole United States of America going against Israel. He will not protect Israel. Israel's on its own. He threw Israel under the bus over the Iran nuclear program. And getting back to Hurricane Sandy. That's why God let it hit the east shoreline there, United States of America. Because that's where our freedom started. Our Republican in 1776, the Republican of the United States of America. And President Obama in 4 years has destroyed it. And what made me sick last night, they're waving flags around there. I know them people love America. But President Obama is going to destroy the America. You know, he don't care about America. He's talking about the New World Agenda. He's Antichrist. The mark of the beast is Obamacare. And I'm crying out to tell you people today, you Christians and you sinners out there that's dancing in the streets of New York City, Times Squares, and Washington, D.C., around the White House, and right there in, Chicago, Illinois, you don't realize, won't be long. You'll be deceived by Obamacare, mark of the beast, on March the 13th, 2013, double whammy 1313 here, you know. And this is time to turn your eyes upon the Lord and give your life to the Lord before it's too late. There's not much time left. And he'll round up the Christians. They'll be taken to FEMA camp. Antichrist Obama will declare martial law. And you're going to see some bad things happening. And Hitler killed 6 million Jews in Europe in World War II. Antichrist Obama, in the next 4 years, 6 million Christians will die a martyr's death because they won't take the mark of the beast. We're going to see some terrible times. And I have the Bible to back up what I'm talking about. This is for the United States of America. We have to do this. You know, God's raiment will always be here. It's not majority of God's people, but his minority, his raiment. In 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verses 11 through 14. And this is when Solomon got the temple get ready to go in. He dedicated it, and this is what God talked to Simon in the Holy Bible here. King Solomon. This is, thus Solomon finished the house of the Lord, and the king's house, and all that came into Solomon's heart to make in the house of the Lord, and in his own house he prosperly effected. And the Lord appeared to Solomon by night, and said unto him, I have heard thy prayer, and have chosen this place to myself for a house of sacrifice. If I shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Now mine eyes shall be open and mine ears attend unto the prayer that is made in this place. Amen, amen. And there are some judgments God's coming on the United States of America. You're going to see tsunamis. You're going to see northeasterns. You're going to see earthquakes. You're going to see tornadoes. It's going to be terrible. You're going to see droughts. You're going to see famines. There's going to be curse on the land. Curse on the land. Why? Because Antichrist Obama went against the Abraham blessing, trying to divide the land there in Israel, the Palestinian state, and God of Israel divided the United States of America. We're divided. Just like the Civil War, we're more divided, you know, in our old time history, United States of America. So watch 2013 and 2014. It's going to come a time that they'll hunt the Christians down and put them in FEMA camps. They'll have to go underground churches or run out in the woods in the wilderness and live off the land. Because the God of Israel has a curse on the United States of America. And another one of his signs was Hurricane Sandy, his judgment on Antichrist Obama. So the next 4 years is going to be like 3.5 years of Antichrist world. And you'll see the mark of the beast. It will happen here. And I believe Obamacare is his vehicle. He's not going to come out. Or Antichrist Obama ain't going to come out. Yeah, here, take the mark of the beast. A lot of people heard of the mark of the beast. It's going to be sneaky, deceitful. But keep your eyes upon Jesus. Don't take the mark of the beast, eternal damnation. Don't take that microchip under your right hand for Obamacare. Or your name won't be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. It's over. So just keep your eyes on Jesus. Say this prayer with me today. And some of you people, it's been running a long time. Maybe some of you never darkened the doors of church. But the next 4 years is going to be the worst years of the United States of America. It's going to be suffering. Worse than a civil war in 1861 to 1865. It's going to be terrible. More homeless people, more people hungry. There won't be no power. It'll be survival mode. It'll be apocalypse. It'll be a terrible time. And you're only going to make it with the grace of God, Jesus' amazing grace, the mercy, the compassion. Christians, this is your time to be street preachers all over the world. Get off your blessed assurance. Get on your feet and hit the streets and tell about Jesus Christ. Save, Jesus saves, Jesus saves. Send the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ. But out there today, sinners, this is your time to turn your life over to the Lord. There's not much time left before the hard times come. If you don't take the mark of the beast, they'll kill you, they'll shoot you with a machine gun, or they'll chop your head off. Take it before the times really get perilous, the times get hard. Say this prayer with me. Confess with your mouth and believe in your heart. Jesus will save your soul instantly, today. Today is the day of salvation. Lord Jesus Christ, I preached what you told me to preach. From the heart, Lord, it's love, not condemnation and guilt. And Lord Jesus, I pray for many souls. I've been going on 28 years of preaching your gospel, King of Kings, and Lord Jesus Christ. Save their souls today in North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Middle East, Far East. This is the time. Lord Jesus, a mighty revival. Send us a mighty revival for salvations, for souls. Wise men win souls. What a price was a soul? What a profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul? Oh God, your soul here at each one of us is priceless. When we accept to be born again, oh Lord Jesus Christ, I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me for my sin. Lord Jesus Christ, I repent of my wicked way. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for saving my soul. Thank you, Jesus, I'm born again. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for writing my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. You said that prayer today. It's your greatest decision. I'm rejoicing with you here at least your brother ministries in Pinckneyville, Illinois. Me and Betty Kelly just made my day. He just made this old preacher shout and get happy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Everything that have breath, praise you. We don't praise you. The hawks are crying, praise you. Oh, Lord Jesus. It's going to be a tough, black Christmas 2012. We're in a belly shadow of death. God, have mercy on our soul. Oh, God, have mercy on the United States of America. Keep praying for George and Betty Cully and Alicia Cully and Alicia Butter Ministry, Pinckneyville, Illinois. We'll be praying for you. Email us. It's on our profile, George and Betty Cully on YouTube. write us. Our address is there on YouTube. We thank YouTube for this video. Oh, we love you. Most important, Jesus loves you. Have a good day. Have a blessed Thanksgiving. And bless Jesus every day. Have a thankful heart, because look, all the blessings. Count your blessings one by one. See what the Lord has done. We are blessed people. United States people are the greatest blessed people in the world. But we're going to go through a valley shadow of death here. Now, starting 2012, it's going to be a black Christmas. Be rough. But 2013 is going to get tough. And 2014 will even get tougher. Just hang on. Hang on, little. Jesus Christ, there's not much time. You know, we might just have 4 years. This might be it. He'll be turning. We don't know when, but we're being prepared and be ready. Thank you. Have a good day. God bless you. Amen. Shalom. 10-4, over out. Sayonara. Have a good day.